Hey, lovebugs, it's Roslynn back at you one more again. I hope everybody is doing blessed. I'm doing blessed and highly favored, and definitely hope the same for you. And if this is your first time stopping by my channel, much love to you and welcome. And to my returning subs, my grown extended beautiful family, just thank you so much for just, you know, embracing your gift, being able to know bigger and better things about the things we're entitled to. It can be overwhelming, but it can also be very well privileged as well. So, you know, just learning the things that we're going along our way can be greatly appreciated. So with that being said, much love to all. Namaste. Love and blessings. Love and light. And many blessings are definitely coming your way. And if you have been watching my videos for a while and have not already, please like and subscribe. Even hit that notification bell so you know when your girl's about to upload her next video. Also, if you are comfortable enough, please drop me a line or two. I love a chance to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me. Even if it's about the positive feedback of the content of my video, or you're just up, tell me about your empathic gift and how it impacted your life and hit you towards positive direction. Also, if you feel like the video has been very informative to you or just gave you some good vibes you would love to share with a loved one, family, or friend, or even a fellow empath that are really going through some really hard times right now and needing confirmation and validation towards their life, please go ahead and share. And while you're at it, give me a thumbs up, like, and also share on your social media favorites wherever you see fit. And once again, thank you so much for the love and support, and I hope you're able to, you know, resonate with the content of my video. And today my meditation music is called Relaxing Music for Stress Relief, Soothing Music for Meditation, Healing Therapy, Sleep, and Spa. You know, we all always need that, you know, because we can end up getting a lot of stress no matter what happens. But anyways, my video today is about Twin Flame 101, Heyokas, when you know you're ready for a relationship after a toxic heartbreak. Oh gosh, we all done had our heartbroken one time or another. And really going through those situations can really put you in a dark place, especially, you know, you could be that type of person that has really went through some downfalls in a relationship. You've been betrayed, you've been cheated on, you could have been abused in mental, emotionally, sexually, physically, or anything, any kind of abuse. They'll make you put walls up to let you think all women are the same, all men are the same. These are some signs to let you know you're ready for, you know, a real relationship. And I really feel like when you go through a situation that's very toxic like that, that puts you in a really dark place, you did everything you supposed to do in a relationship, you know, neither one of your, you know, the other is perfect or whatever. We live and we learn from a lot of things, but just to, you know, just to be able to look forward in the future, you know, even if it puts you in a dark place, you know, people are feared to get married, people are feared to, you know, be in a committed relationship because they're feeling like, oh, okay, the next person is, you know, going to put me in a really bad situation. And that's not always the case. You know, usually you have to try to date outside the norm. You know, you shouldn't go back and deal with the same kind of type of people that you've been dealing with before, you know, especially if they've really put you in a dark place. You need to go try to, you know, change it up a little bit. So here's a few techniques or a few signs you can tell if you're ready for, you know, a real, you know, real relationship, or you're heading towards a real relationship after being in a toxic heartbreak. When you start realizing the relationship that you were in, you know, was basically lessons and blessings. It taught you how to communicate, how to trust, how to be able to disagree to agree, be able to, when you can both agree on things, you're really trying to not contemplate, but God dog, I can't really remember the daggone word I'm trying to look for. But basically, you can agree to disagree. Y'all can be able to, you know, agree on, okay, well, if we don't have to do this, but, you know, we can do this as well. So it's just like when you can look at the situation you were in and look at it like, you know what, you know, a lot of people were like, you know, I was even at that type, oh, I wish I never met that person. Ooh, that person really put me in a dark place. You never should say that because that's the person you wanted at that time. And it might not have worked out. You know, they might have cheated or, you know, was very narcissistic, you know, but then past, we tend to get those type of people in our lives, like sociopaths, psychopaths. I've been through that, you know, just currently getting out of one myself. After a few years, and being able to see all the things that, you know, that you didn't do in your last relationship, is go ahead and, you know, you learn from those situations, learn what kind of red flags to look for. being able to get your strength back after a really dark relationship, being able to see yourself like, okay, you know, I might be ready, but I always feel like when you're still healing, a lot of people do, you know, break up, and the next thing you know, they jump into another relationship, and they should grieve over that little relationship and being able to heal. I mean, you don't have to grieve for months and months and months at a time, but you should be able to heal yourself first before you jump into another relationship, because you don't need, you know, the bad situation that you had in one relationship carrying on to a next one. You know, especially if that person is not showing the signs that they're like the last person you were with. You don't want to cut that person just because the other person did that to you. You don't want to bring that into your situation. So I always tell people, as well as myself, give yourself that time to heal. Give yourself that time to know what you have to bring to the table. What are you going to accept? What are you not going to accept? Are you fully able to love yourself in all aspects of your life? You know, when you're able to heal from those situations and being able to say, you know what? Yes, this was a really bad relationship. Yes, it put me in a really dark place. But you know what? I learned a lot of things from that relationship. It has taught me a lot. You know, my last relationship taught me strength, you know, self-respect, wisdom, strength in places I never thought I would before. Being able to say, you know what, if you can't respect me and learn how to appreciate me, I don't need to be with you. You know, being able to not want to jump in another relationship. I've did that before, just like, you know, you don't need a rebound or something like that. You know, like this singer called K. Michelle, she was like, I got with another man just to get over the last one. And I have friends, you know, I have friends and relatives that's like that. And I'm like, man, you need to give yourself time to heal, you know. And they're like, I just don't want to be alone. You have to be able to be your own best friend. I really feel that way. You have to be your own best friend, being able to know you're okay with being your own company for a while, because that gives you time to work on you, to better yourself in so many different levels. Being able to know, you know what, am I ready for a relationship? That's why this is with me. I choose celibacy. I'm not submitting to nobody. If I know that this person is not right for me, or, you know, I'm not ready to get into a relationship, because I noticed a lot of guys will try to talk to me, as well as females, and it's just all about sexual sense. And I'm just like, no, if I can do that on my own, I don't need nobody else to be doing all that. I don't want a sexual relationship. I don't have time for that. You know, I'm ready to be in a relationship where I can be committed. You know, it's just me and that other person. So it's just like, you have to be able to learn to know that, okay, am I healed all the way? Do I love myself in all levels? Am I able to trust again? Am I able to love again? Am I still holding on to that baggage? You know, some people get into another relationship and still talking about their ex. The person you're with does not want to hear about the last person you were with. You know, if they, you know, because I've been with another, you know, a person, they asked me about my last relationship. I'm like, I really don't want to talk about that. You know, well, we're together. Let's just work on us. Let's just talk about, you know, what we want to talk about when it comes to us. I don't want to never talk about that relationship, you know, unless it's like something really dark has happened to me and you ask. That's a different story. But just to up and talk about that person, you know, your new person don't want to hear about that, because they're going to still think you're still salty about the last relationship you were with. So you want to kind of like leave that alone and be able to know, you know, can we talk about, you know, what we're going to accept, what we got both to bring to the table, what kind of relationship you're looking for. A while back, people used to, you know, ask me when we were on the verge of talking or whatever, ask me what did I want in a relationship. I couldn't really tell them, because I never knew what true love really was. I thought I experienced true love, but there was always hidden motives behind it. It was either control issues, or, you know, trying to get me to where, you know, you can just basically do anything to me. So I never really were able to experience that. But it's just like, you know, with the situation I'm in now, being able to see, you know, from the outside, and I step back saying, you know what, you know, if it happens, I'm ready for it, you know. But right now, this gives me that time to heal, enjoy myself, and be able to enjoy my own company. Being able to say, you know what, not every man or woman, whoever I decide to be with, is not going to be like everybody else, because I know what to look for. I know what questions to ask, just to see how they answer. You know, watch the words as well as their actions that they put behind their words. So it educates you a lot when you have been through a toxic relationship. Being able to say, you know what, yeah, this was a really messed up relationship I was in, but not every person is the same. You know, you can tell when people are bitter and still angry. You know, I was at that point, you know,
but I didn't never say, oh, all men are the same or all women are the same or anything like that. You just have to be able to be cautious and look out what to look for. You know what, know what to look for. So when you finally are able to encounter that perfect love, this perfect in your eyes, no relationship is perfect, but you know, being able to compromise, that's the word I was looking for, compromise, being able to compromise in your relationship, you know, having good, you know, good conversation, being able to talk about things instead of arguing and fighting. Nobody wants to argue. I don't got time for all that. You know, I did that in my last relationship where we all argued because, you know, he was womanizing and he was cheating all the time. And, you know, and it, plus narcissistic and sociopath, you know, Prince Charming. And then next thing you know, start seeing all type of red flags, messing with all type of people. But that relationship has really taught me a lot. And I'm blessed to be, you know, being able to experience that, because that was my ultimate heartbreak, because I never thought that person would ever do that to me, because I accept them and flaws and all. But you know, once you be in a relationship, and you know, when cheating shouldn't be allowed, because you, if you relate, you know, you respect your relationship, you're not going to do that. If you feel like they're on the verge of doing that, you know, you always should talk it out. And then if it's something that they choose to want to do, part your ways. You know, it beats, I'd rather be hurt for that quick minute then be hurt behind something else, and it'll be detrimental to my life. I don't know. You got time. So being able to do that and see that you have good communication skills with another person, you know, is a blessing. Being able to know y'all can communicate and compromise with each other, being able to respect your relationship and ask, you know, it's not like you're saying, oh, this person controls me. But if you're making decisions as a couple, you should always run it by your, you know, your significant other and make sure they don't have issues or problems with that, you know, because they don't want to catch them off guard. So when you know you're all ready for those things, these are the things you need to look for, because some people are like, dang, am I ready to date? You know, you have to be able to have that wall down to be open, you know, really be open. It's just with me, I choose not to, you know, because I feel like, you know, when that person is in my life and I'll know it, you know, because it's just like people I come across, they'll come talk to me or whatever, and I don't feel that, you know, they give me chills, or, you know, make that, you know, my chill, you know, give me chill bumps or whatever, or make my heart skip a beat. So I'm already not going to waste my time with that. It's just like, ah, nice to meet you, but no, I'm not interested. You know, I have to have that person in my life like that. So when you're able to know if you're ready for a relationship, those things should be, if you should be able to ask yourself that, you know, if I took time enough to grieve and, you know, understand what happened in my relationship, where did I fail? Where did they fail? What do I need to look for? What did I learn? What has this situation taught me? You know, do I have walls up? Do I have insecurity issues? Do I have trust issues? Do I, you know, am I going to sit up here and bring my old relationship baggage to the next relationship baggage? These are all the things you need to ask yourself. And if they're, you know, mostly everything is more in the pros instead of the cons, hey, you're ready to go. So I hope you are able to resonate with the video. Drop me a line. Let me know what you feel about your situation, or you feel like you are ready for a relationship. And if you need any questions that I can help answer, I will gladly be able to do that as best as I know how. And, you know, drop me a line. Give me a thumbs up, like, and also share. And, you know, drop me a line so I can go ahead and give you a shout out on my next video. And know that you are truly blessed, highly favored, and forever loved, and knowing there's always somebody out there praying for better days. So much love to you, and I'm going to give a post notification shout out to Donald J. and Amber G. Much love. Peace. Be wild.